Hello students, myself is Dr. Dhanya PM, Associate Professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, RSET. In this presentation, we will be dealing with Simplified Instructional Computers, which is coming under CS303 System Softwares. Simplified Instructional Computers, in short, we can call it as SIC. It is only a hypothetical computer that is designed in order to study the assembly level programming. This particular computer includes all the hardware features found on real machines, but certain irrelevant complexities are avoided. This SIC comes in two versions. First one is standard model. The second is XE version, which is extra equipment or extra component. Both this SIC and SIC XE versions are upward compatible. That means if you are writing a program in SIC language, it will work on SIC XE machine also. Architecture of an SIC machine. First of all, let us see memory. We all know that memory consists of many locations, and each location is having a unique memory address. In the case of an SIC machine, one memory location can store a maximum of 8 bits, or otherwise 1 byte. Memory address of an SIC machine is of length 15 bits. So altogether, 2^15 different memory locations can be addressed. Now, 3 consecutive bytes form a word. That is 8 into 3 equal to 24 bits. Now, let us see the registers used. There are mainly 5 registers, and the registers will be of size 24 bits. The registers are register A, register X, register L, program counter, and status word. They are having the number 0, 1, 2, 8 and 9 respectively. And they are designed for special use. For example, register A, which is also called as accumulator, is used in the case of arithmetic operations. And register X is also known as index register, is used in addressing. Register L, which is also known as linkage register, is used to store the return address in a jump to subroutine. And PC, there is a program counter, will always be storing the address of the next instruction to be executed. Now SW, that is a status word, it will be storing the status of certain operations. Data format. SIC machine mainly deals with two types of data. First one is integer data, second is character data. And the integers will be of length 24 bits. And it will be in 2's complement format. Characters are represented in ASCII code, which is of 8-bit length. And in an SIC machine, you cannot store floating point numbers. Now, instruction format. Instructions in an SIC machine consists of 2 sections. One is the opcode, and the second section is the operand section. The opcode is of length 8 bit and the operand is of length 15 bits. Now there is an X bit which takes the value either 0 or 1. If X is equal to 1, then that type of addressing is called indexed addressing. We will see the use of X bit in detail. Before that, we have to study what a target address is. A target address means it is address of the memory location in which the operands is stored. Now, if X equal to 0, the target address will be the same as that of the address mentioned in the instruction. But if X equal to 1, then we have to calculate the target address by adding the contents of register X and the address specified in the instruction. Instruction set of an SIC machine. Load store instructions. Loading means moving the data from the memory to a register, and store means moving the data from a register to a memory. And the load instructions are LDA, LDX, and store instructions are STA, STX. So LDA means loading accumulator with the contents of memory. And LDX means loading the X register with the contents of memory. STA is storing the contents of accumulator to the memory, and STX means moving the contents of X register to the memory. So both this load and store are reverse operations. Now arithmetic instructions, they are add, sub, multiply and divide. All these operations involve register A and also a word memory. The result after this operation will be stored in register A. Now comparison instruction. This instruction will be comparing the value in register A with the value stored in memory. Depending upon the result of comparison, a condition code will be set. That is, if register A contains a value less than that of the memory, condition code will be less. If both are equal, condition code will be equal to. If register A is having a value greater than the value in memory, greater than will be set in condition code. And based on this condition code, there are three different types of jump instructions. They are jump on less than, jump on equal to, jump on greater than. LDA, LDX, STA and STX in detail. We will see LDA 5 first. LDA 5 means loading the contents of memory location 5 to accumulator. So as in the figure, memory location 5 is having the integer 5 that is taken to accumulator. Now LDX 5, that means load the contents of memory location 5 to X register. So in the figure, integer 5 is stored in memory location 5. So that is taken to X register. Now STA alpha. So it is a store operation which moves the contents of the register to the memory location. So STA alpha means we are moving the contents of accumulator to the memory location alpha. So in the figure, 20 is moved to the memory location alpha. Now STX alpha means store the contents of X register to memory location alpha. So 20, which is the contents of X register, is taken to the memory location alpha. Add and sub instruction. First we will see add 5. Add 5 means add the contents of the memory location 5 with the contents of accumulator, and the result after addition is stored in accumulator. We can see that the memory location 5 is having the integer 5 and that is added with the 15, and the result 20 is stored in accumulator. Next is sub 5. Sub 5 means subtract the contents of memory location 5 from the contents of accumulator. So 15 minus 5, 10 is stored in accumulator. Multiply and division instruction. Multiply 5, that means the contents of memory location 5 is to be multiplied with the contents of accumulator and the result is to be stored in accumulator. You can see that 5 into 5 is 75 is stored in accumulator. Next is div 5, that is contents of accumulator is to be divided with the contents of memory location 5. So 15 divided by 5, 3 is stored in accumulator. Comparison instruction. Let us see compare alpha. This means the contents of accumulator is to be compared with the contents of memory location alpha. Here we can see that both the contents are same. Since both are same, the condition code in the status word will be set to equal to. Another example is compare beta. Here, the contents of accumulator is compared with the contents of memory location beta. Here we can see that contents of accumulator is greater than the contents of memory location beta. So, a greater than is set in the condition code, the set of the status word. Conditional jump JLT. JLT stands for jump on less than. Consider the small program given in the slide. We have compare alpha and JLT sigma. That means compare the contents of accumulator and alpha, and if the condition code is set to less than, it has to jump to the instruction with the label sigma. So as in the figure, accumulator is having the value 15 and the memory location is alpha is having the value 30. So the condition code will be set to less than. So the program will jump to the instruction which is having the label sigma, and the add A instruction will be executed. Conditional jump JGT. Let us see the small program given in the slide. Compare alpha and JGT gamma. Here, the contents of accumulator and that of the memory location alpha will be compared, and if the contents of accumulator is greater than that of the other, then the program will jump to the instruction labeled by gamma. That instruction is add B. The same is demonstrated in the figure. Conditional jump JEQ. So here we have the program compare alpha and JEQ gamma. That is, it will compare the contents of accumulator and the contents of memory location alpha, and if both are equal, then the control will go to the instruction with the label gamma. Subroutine linkage instructions JSUB and RSUB. JSUB is jump to subroutine, RSUB is return from subroutine. Input output instructions. Input output instructions are test device, read data and write data. Read data is to read data from an input device, write data is to write data to an output device. Before doing these operations, we have to test whether the device is ready or not. If device is ready, the condition code will be set to less than. If condition code is set to equal to, then device is not ready. Jump to subroutine JSUB and return from subroutine RSUB. Consider the program given in the slide. JSUB M means jump to the subroutine with the label M. As seen in the figure, let JSUB M as a memory address 1003. Since it is a 4 bytes instruction, the next instruction is available in the location 1007. While JSUB is taken into CPU for execution, PC will increment to the address of the next instruction, that is, it will increment to 1007. Since JSUB is already a jump instruction, 1007 is to be saved in register L so that on return from the subroutine, it will continue its execution from 1007. And the new address 100B, which is a subroutine address, is loaded into the program counter. Once the execution of subroutine is over, it will return from it using the RSUB instruction. Now the previous content of PC, which is 1007, is restored to it from the L register. Here we will see the working of test device RD and WD. So we know that if you want to read data from an input device or write data to an output device, we need to test whether the device is ready for that transfer. This is done using the instruction TD. So the format is TD followed by the device name. So as in the program, you can see that TD in device means it will check whether the input device named in device is ready or not. If it is ready, CC in status word will be set to less than. Otherwise, it is set to equal to. So the SIC program keep on checking the CC until it is set to less than. So until it is set to less than, the program keeps on looping to R loop. Once the device is ready, it will come out of that loop and read data from the input device. Similar execution can be seen in the case of write data, which is writing data to the output device. The output device is tested and checked to see whether it is ready or not. When it is ready, the data will be returned to the output device. So in this presentation, we have seen the architecture of an SAC machine, its memory, various registers, data formats, instruction format, and the instruction set. Thank you all.